just wanted to fill you in on my week with Monate. Believe it or not, I haven't washed my hair in about 4 days. Normally I can go 4 days when it's blow-dry straight, but I actually, like 4 days ago, I washed my hair and I did it curly. And I used the Moxie Magnifying Mousse. I did hear a lot of good things about it, so I figured I'd try it. And because I do like to wear my hair curly a lot of the time, so I did actually really like the mousse. And I don't like a lot of like curl creams and curling products generally. I have my like specific favorites, and I actually really did like it. So that's awesome. Normally I can go about 2 days with it curly, and I kind of re-wet the curls, you know, on the second day, and then I could put like a little bit of more mousse or product in it, and it'll be good for one more day. And then usually by the second day of it being curly, I have to rewash it. Whereas if I blow dry it, I can go a good 4 or 5 days, just keep re-blow drying it, and it'll still look nice. Maybe put a little bit of dry shampoo. So, you know, up until today, my hair being curly really did look good. I actually could keep wetting it every single day, and my curls would spring up. So that's a really good sign as far as what Monate is doing to my hair, and you know, good testimony for the mousse. So just wanted to give you curly girls like an idea, you know, on you know, basically Monate and how it can help your curls. So that being said, I do feel like my roots are more oily using the Monate, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. You know, it's kind of keeping your natural oils in your hair. I don't think that it's something that I couldn't deal with. So 3 weeks in, I'm not saying it's going through any sort of crazy detox that, you know, a lot of people kind of talked about, at least not yet for me. So what do I want to talk about other than that? Basically using the same products that I've, you know, talked about in the last couple weeks. I did do the mask the day that I did do my hair curly. So 4 days ago I did the mask. And I just used the Renew shampoo. This is actually the Revive, but I used the Renew shampoo. So a little bit more moisturizing. This one, the Revive, is for volume. I used the Revitalize conditioner. I used the Replenish mask. I love the leave-in conditioner. I use that after every wash. Just give me a little extra softness and smoothness, and it really does work. And then I put the split end mender right on my tips. And then, you know, if I was to blow dry my hair out using the blow dryer and hot tools, curl and iron, I would put the blowout cream in it because that gives some heat protectant. And I think that's about it. So right now I'm gonna go wash my hair once again because it really, really, really needs it. And I'm gonna use, you know, basically all these things, and we can touch base after. I will blow dry it and you can see how it is, you know, once it's smooth, see how my split ends are doing. I'm curious to see. And so I actually have not had it blow dried straight since last week, so. All right, see you guys soon. You guys, we're using the Revive shampoo actually. I decided to try it. I haven't used it yet. It's for more volume, so we'll see. So I'm just sitting here with the shampoo on my hair. This was the second shampoo that we just did. So each shampoo you have to leave it on for 2 to 3 minutes. So we're just waiting here now, and then we're gonna rinse again, and we're gonna do the regular conditioner, the Revitalize conditioner. All right. Okay, we just rinsed out the shampoo. So now it's time to add the Revitalize conditioner. And you don't even need to leave that on, actually. You can just rinse it right out. So run it through and make sure it's evenly distributed. Kind of run it through your fingers, detangle your hair. It actually glides really, really, really good through your hair. So then you can just rinse it right out. You don't have to leave it in. Okay, so I just blow dried my hair. Before I blow dried it, I ended up putting the leave-in conditioner, like I always do, and I put in the blow dry cream. Anytime you want to use hot tools or any sort of heat, you want to use the blow dry cream as a protectant. So again, you know, just like last week, I feel like my hair is very silky, it's smooth, it has like a really nice softness to it. It definitely feels like airy, it feels voluminous. I use the Revive shampoo this time instead of the Renew. And I do feel like it feels like a little lighter, like just more bouncy and flowy. So that's a cool, you know, cool thing to know. Maybe I should, when I want a little more volume, use the Revive. Also, I forgot to mention that I did get the deep smoothing shampoo and conditioner in this week. So next week for my video, I'll try that and we'll see how that works. It's supposed to add a little extra moisture, which my hair definitely needs. That's my main problem. Not so much hair loss, but or thinness or anything like that, but dryness. So I'm really looking at the end of this trial, the 2 to 3 months that I'll be, you know, featuring these videos. I really want to see what happens with the texture of my hair. That's my main goal, is to see, you know, if my hair gets really just a lot healthier, and mainly the quality, because I don't suffer with any sort of real thinness, so I don't really think that's gonna change much. I might be pleasantly surprised and have like this crazy big amount of hair, but that's not my main concern. So just to share one thing that I know from the different reviews that I've seen on YouTube, is one of the biggest complaints is the detox phase that you supposedly go through. So this is week 3. As I mentioned earlier, I didn't really think I was going through any sort of detox except for a little bit of extra oiliness at my root. But to be completely candid and unbiased, I want to share with you guys that after I put all the styling products in my hair just now, and I combed through it with a wide tooth comb, I had a really big knot, like a mat. And I can show it to you right here. So if you want to check that out, it's kind of a large mat. You can see it on my hands. So I'll tell you why I'm not overly concerned. This is not uncommon for me. I do get, you know, definitely some, you know, shedding. I mean, my hair is curly, it's gonna get tangled, and when I comb it out, it's gonna shed. I do have a lot of excess hair that's on my hairbrush all the time, so I'm not gonna say that that was Monate that did that. But also, I want to say that, you know, Monate claims that your hair will shed. That is part of the detox phase. Some people are, you know, scared of that. But, you know, their scientific kind of explanation basically is that it's removing all of that buildup and all of those dead skin cells from your hair follicles. So therefore, your hair follicle will technically be, you know, small with all of those dead skin cells build up all kind of caked into it. And then when it's removing all of that gunk that's in it, your hair follicle is larger and the hair will tend to shed, it will fall out. And that's all part of the process that you have to get through. So it will have like a little shedding phase, and then you'll notice a ton of regrowth following. We'll see. I mean, I'm at the point where, okay, we have the shedding. I'm not afraid. Especially, I also wanna say that, you know, I did not wash my hair for 4 days and I left it curly. I left it scrunchy, which means obviously anyone that has curly hair knows that, you know, once you do it, you don't really comb it out. You can't touch your curls other than putting a little bit of water in and re-scrunching them. So all of that, you know, hair that should have shed over the last 4 days didn't. It kind of just got stuck in my hair. And you saw my hair earlier, it was up in like a kind of rat's nest little bun. So obviously I would have more shedding this time around versus last week when I combed it out. So just to take that into consideration, but yeah, I wanted to be open and honest and just show you what, you know, what kind of shedding I'm having, and just so that you know what probably is normal versus not normal if you're experiencing the same type of shedding if you are using Monate now. So I think that's about it. As you can see, my hair is pretty silky. It's, you know, I just blow dried it. I will take some still shots. I did forget to take still shots after last week, week two. So I'll probably just do, I'll just skip that one. We'll have still shots from 1, 3, 4, 5, 6 weeks. No big deal, I just skipped 1 week, but I will take some still shots so you can see up close what my hair looks like. But my split ends, I really feel like they're not as bad as they were. I don't feel like they're as frayed. If you look back in my previous videos, it kind of seems like, you know, I had a lot more fraying at the ends, but it's really hard to pick out the, you know, the actual hairs that have splits on them now, where before they, you know, were really apparent. So, I mean, maybe it is really healing my hair and kind of mending it. So that I'm definitely happy about. And just overall, I mean, it's, I don't have any tangles at all. Where using any other smoothing serums that I used to use Qi, you know, the Qi brand serum. I mean, just all different products. I used to try like everything on the market. And I could never just do this after blow drying it. It just wouldn't really, my hands would always snag, you know, on the end. So that's a good thing I like. I can toss my hair all over the place and it doesn't really get tangled. So I think I touched upon everything. If you have any questions, you can definitely comment or send me messages. But I think that's all. I will see you guys next week. All right, thank you. Tune in to Moni Mondays, everybody.